It swings and drives it way back.
Pike is destroyed by Ramel Pratt.
Shot, drop step, turnaround.
Jumper to Scott. Scott throws it down with a left hand slam. Kept alive by Landisburg, tips it ahead to Farrakhan. He's going to throw it down with a one-hand jam.
Cavalier Sports Weekly is brought to you by GEICO, the Virginia Athletics Foundation, the Virginia Lottery, and by UVA Health Systems.
On this edition of Cavalier Sports Weekly,
they are without question the greatest group of seniors that we've ever seen in Virginia swimming history.
Welcome to Cavalier Sports Weekly. I'm Scott Robison from the men's swimming and diving team. We've got seven different sports represented on today's show. Let's start off with our play of the week.
Called strike three. Strike three. Side corner called strike three. Swung on and missed.
I thought Danny Holtzen was terrific. 14 strikeouts and 6 2/3 innings is just really tremendous.
Called out looking. Swing and a miss.
Strike three call. 10 of them now. Punch out number 11. Swung on and missed. Swing and a miss. It's 14 of them now for Danny Holtzen.
Stay tuned. Virginia game highlights are coming up next. This portion of Cavalier Sports Weekly is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Welcome back to the show. Our men's basketball team was in Greensboro, North Carolina this week for one of the nation's greatest sporting events, the ACC tournament. Let's check out the highlights.
Miami scored the next five and got their first lead at 11-8. Here's Evans attacking down the lane. He scoops it off the window and good use of the right hand. Linsky will reset it again. Now he's going to launch up a long-range three, and he touches all net. Sammy Zaglinski gets his first long ball of the day, and the Hoos go ahead 23-20. Scott dribbles with the right hand, attacking on Farrakhan, nearly lost it, but holds on to the dribble. Now they'll back it out with inside of 10 seconds to shoot. Carries Adams, pulls up his 17-foot jumper, is up and good. Pass comes down low to Gamble. Gamble pump fake. Cheryl stays with him nicely, but he makes a nice jump hook anyway. Julian Gamble has done a huge job for his team. A.T. Harrell attacks underneath. He tries to power a shot up into traffic. No good. Harris picks up a loose ball, though. He tries to power it up. No good. Asad Sen with a rebound and the stick back. Looking to set something up. Now to Harris, near wing right. Joe Harris, skip pass over to Harrell, all by himself. Passed up on a three. Steps inside the arc, and he splashes one through from 17 feet out. Harris has it in the corner. Backs out. Sends it to Harrell. He pump fakes. Puts it up in the lane. Teardrop counter with a foul. K.T. Harrell puts Virginia ahead by one with a free throw pending.
I really want it for our seniors and for our program to get into a game to play the number one seed in this tournament and keep improving. That I thought would have been a real important step. I wanted that very badly for them. But then certainly that would have, you know, added to his head winning 5 out of 6. But to step back and look at it, there was some good basketball played by our guys.
Who's by two? Jontel Evans, far wing left. He dribbles with the left hand, gets a screen from Asad Sen, finds the opening, blasts through it and lays it in off the window. Miami just 8 points in our opening 15 minutes. Here's a skip pass. Harris finds KT Harrell, and he bangs it home from the far corner. Call it a two-pointer. Virginia leads by 6. Jontel Evans sends it into Zaglinski. Three-pointer on the way. He got it. Sammy Zaglinski fading away on the near corner right. With 17 seconds to shoot. He's got it. Now pass to Harris. Harris dropped it, but picked it up on the carom. Sits the pass down to Asad Sen, who lays it in off the window. Oh, it's all going right now. Virginia leads by 11.
To get to that point, I liked what I saw. I felt good. And then it changed quick.
30 seconds to go. Malcolm Grant, top of the arc, lets it fly from three. This one's in. He rattles it through from the top of the arc. What would be one of the more improbable comebacks in the history of this tournament. Here's the inbound pass. Gamble will stuff it down with a two-hand dunk. Nobody got in his way. Here comes the inbound pass from Jontel Levis. Needs some help. Going to send it in. It's going to be taken by Durant Scott. He puts it up with a foul with 13.9 seconds to go.
For us, everything that could go wrong had to go wrong, and then they had a finish.
Free throw is up. It's off the iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Zaglinski, but he lost it out of bounds. He and Mustafa Farrakhan had it between them. Grant has it, 7 seconds to play. Tie game. He's at the top of the arc. Had the ball slapped away. 2 seconds to go. Virginia's got it. The coaches, the broadcasters, everybody's feeling the pressure now. Malcolm Grant crossing over on Evans. Kicks it out. Darius Adams gets a good look at a three, and he splashes it through from the far wing right. Cavaliers have a chance. It's still a two-possession game, but they need some way to stop that ball from going through and get that back. Here's Reggie Johnson. Puts up a jump hook, and he gets the friendly roll. It goes down. Miami is up by 8.
Our offseason will be significant. Guys will have to improve. The plan will be to get Mike Scot back. He has to obviously get his waiver and all that, but that'll help us. But right now, it feels like we should be getting ready and playing tomorrow at noon, but we're not.
Now let's check in with our 6th-ranked baseball team.
Holton's 0-2 delivery to Schaefer. On its way, swung on and missed, strike three, got him on a breaking ball. The pitch to Epps, swung on and missed, strike three.
I thought Danny Holton was terrific tonight. Clemson's got a very good ball club. You know, he was in control of the game from the start. He had a few walks and pitched himself into some situations, but he pitched out of it and had 14 strikeouts and 6 2/3 innings. It's just really tremendous. And, you know, when you start a weekend series out with a guy like that on the mound, it gives you a pretty good chance.
A little bit of an open stance in that right-handed batter's box, and Wiseman's first pitch to him is swung on, hit right back up the box into center field, base hit. Rounding third and headed plateward is Barr. The throw will be to Kibu, not in time.
When you have a lead with Danny Holton pitching, you got a tremendous chance to win.
2-2 pitch to Epp, strike three called. 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. So that'll be a double and an E4. And Holton swings the first pitch and flies towards Schausen left. He makes the catch, the tag, and coming down the line and scoring easily is John Hicks, and it's a 2-0 Virginia lead. Everyone down there playing the role of spectator as Holton cruising here in the 6th. The payoff again, swung on and missed. Fastball upstairs, and that is strikeout number 12 for the reigning ACC Pitcher of the Year, Danny Holton. Here's the 1-0. Lined out into center field. Lamb coming on. He's not going to be able to get it. It falls for a base hit. Taylor drives in a run. The 0-2 pitch again, and it's chopped out towards short, backing in. Miller booted the ball. Went over his left shoulder, out into the outfield, and that'll be an error, and a run scores. Which means either Holton is going to come back or whoever was throwing is ready to come in. Runner goes on the 0-2, and it's lined into center field for a base hit. Scoring from third is Moerman, and on his way and into third easily is Hicks, and it's 5-0 Virginia. And Holton with the 2-2 pitch to him, and a strike three called on the outside corner. Fourth time Miller is punched out tonight. Third time looking, and that's 14 of them now for Danny Holton. And the payoff pitch, and he struck him out swinging, and that's the ball game.
This portion of Cavalier Sports Weekly is brought to you by UVA Health Systems.
Every fourth-year swimmer on both the men's and women's teams have now won an ACC championship every year they've been at UVA. That's 8 titles in the last 4 years. Pretty amazing stuff.
This is a very, very special group of women. We've said it many, many times, but they're as close as sisters. They really and truly care about one another as good friends, as teammates. They've never placed themselves above each other. They've always viewed themselves as one entity. They're one in their own minds and in their own hearts, and they bring a lot of different personalities to the mix, but they blended those personalities beautifully. They're without question the greatest group of seniors that we've ever seen in Virginia swimming history. It'll take a lot for any group to match or exceed what this group has accomplished, but certainly I've been very, very blessed to be able to work with these eight women and watch them grow and watch them prosper, and I think their future is every bit as bright as what they've accomplished as athletes.
Winning four in a row with this group of girls, it was amazing, and we, over our 4 years here, have become like sisters. And we started out with 12 girls, and we're down to 8, and these 8 girls are the closest group of girls that have ever gone through this program in my 4 years. And we love each other, and to accomplish what we accomplished all together as a family was really incredible, and we have grown closer through it.
This group of men has never lost a championship meet in the conference. They have been defeated once in a dual meet. I don't think that's anything they've ever talked about collectively as a group. I think they grew a lot from that loss, and I think that, you know, you learn just as much when you lose as when you win. That loss happened all the way back in their first year. Somehow, some way, they resolved never to feel that sting of loss again in the ACC, and they were able to stay true to their word and true to their belief in what they were going to accomplish as a group.
In a program like this, you know, we do everything together. So these are, you know, our class is my, you know, closest group of friends. We do everything together, so to be able to share something like with them is, you know, really special.
Yeah, I mean, that was really important for us to go out like that. And we're all a very close class. We all love each other. But it wasn't just us along the 4 years that won all four of those championships. It was all the other guys that we swam with as well, and all of the other classes that came before us and taught us how to do it. Not just, you know, our first, second, and third year, but 5, 6, 7 years down back, the guys that we didn't swim with who were the ones who learned how to win a championships and passed it down to us. So it was really, really important, and something that we will definitely cherish for a long time.
Our number 2 ranked men's lacrosse team had a pair of games this week, and we've got the stories for you.
Today, it's lacrosse on the big stage. Live from M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, the number 2 ranked Virginia Cavaliers take on number 9 Cornell. It's a public Ivy versus the private Ivy, the Big Red versus the Wahoos, now. Pinnell up the right pipe, left alone on top, shot, score. Lop here down the right pipe, freeze the right hand, fires, and goal. Chris LaPierre just blasted a hole in the net. That's why they call him Shocker. Slightly unsettled as Rommel down the left side. Head of steam as he enters the box. Now spins away from the cage. Fires low and scores. Clockwork for Rommel Bratton, and he brings Virginia within one.
I don't feel like there was a lot of magic in the air most of the day for us. Seemed like we were really kind of struggling a little bit on offense in particular. But we worked hard. I thought we would continue to work. I thought we did the same thing last Friday night up in the Dome. We worked, and our effort almost carried us through last week and was able to kind of carry us through today. Colin, you know, since the beginning of the season, has stepped up and has been making plays for us consistently. You could see it and probably saw it at the end of last year and through the preseason. And, you know, we have been figuring out different ways to get Colin on the field in different situations so he can continue to make those kind of plays for us.
Let's go on, best half of lacrosse right here. Get it off the ground, everybody, lots of energy. Let's go get it.
Ryan Benincasa's won another faceoff for Virginia.
Benincasa, you know, came in and, you know, probably did more for us today than we'd asked him to do in any of the games, and I thought he was very good.
White throws it left side. Emery fakes the pass, steps forward. Low angle shot. Oh, my goodness, he ripped it up a right corner. Flag down again, slow whistle. Rommel trying to get inside, keeps the ball in his stick. Oh, behind the back shot, scores! Rommel Bratton through the teeth of the defense. Bratton stepping forward, face dodge, gets inside, fires right.
I thought late in the game today, Adam really stepped, just stood up, and that's what you expect from a senior and a four-year starter.
Who's win? 11-9. Cavaliers get it done.
Last Sunday, our women's lacrosse team took on Penn State at Klockner Stadium. Prior to the game, the team permanently retired the number one worn by Yardley Love.
I think we were all prepared to have that ceremony today. The girls were part of the decision-making process to retire Yardley's number and then to wear the L's on her sleeves and the flag, so they weren't surprised by any of that. I think to have Sharon and Lex and Jamie here with us on the field, I think it brought us all back. It definitely got to our heart, which I think was the point of it. But all in all, we were happy to have that celebration done so well and to have the Love family with us. I thought it was great. And so many people coming out and really applauding the whole time, too, really made it extra special.
Passes off to Baker, splits to the left. Baker gets a left hand free, fires and scores. And now Josie Owen steps in her junior year to take the draw. Draw popped up high in the air. Owen scrapes it out of the sky. Brings it down and then tried to find Julie Gardner, who dropped it and picked it up. Cavs in a bit of a transition here. Julie Gardner at the goal. A two-on-one. Gardner feeds left pipe. Shot score by the Cavaliers. And it is Ann Thomas who tucks it top shelf. Dunbar circling herself in front of the cage. Feeds a cutter. Shot score. Baker in Virginia with a three-on-three. Baker's beat her player. And now Baker in with a two-on-one. Looking to her left. Feeds Finnegan. Fires left-handed and scores. Gardner underneath the scoreboard here at Klockner Stadium. It says Virginia 4, Penn State 2. Gardner just rotating. And now feeds right side. Owen, dip and dunk, scores. Ball behind the cage. Josie Owen feeds the cutter. Man, open shot, score. Julie Gardner with the quick stick. Back to the cage now, driving in as Mary Dean spins towards the bank. Ball saved by Kolarik, who match sticks. Turns down the right pipe. Free, fires, scores on the bounce shot.
Torrential downpour to light drizzle to a little bit of everything, but all in all, we're glad that we got the game in today and that so many people were able to go from one venue to the next. You know, they played a lot of defense in that last 22 minutes. You know, clearly Penn State's got enough attackers, they could get some goals going, but I thought that Kim and our defense really stood up and made some stands when they needed to.
Coming up after the break. This portion of Cavalier Sports Weekly is brought to you by the Virginia Athletics Foundation.
Under head coach Mike London, our football team has a renewed commitment to community service. Last week, a number of players and assistant coach Sean Moore visited a local elementary school as part of National Read Aloud Week.
Finally, the doctor gave his orders. Tiki bent his knee back and forth. Go slow, the doctor said. Take it easy. Rondé took the old football out of the closet and passed it to his brother. It was the first football the twins had ever owned, a gift from their grandmother.
I had the pleasure of reading to the four-year-olds, preschool, and we read a book by Tiki and Rondé, my brother by my side, and the children loved it.
Today, Woodbrook Elementary School decided to kick off National Read Aloud Week. It is a national campaign that really sends a message to elementary school age children and really everybody the importance of reading aloud. And so we partnered with the University of Virginia's football team to have the guys come out and spend a little time in our classrooms reading aloud to kids and sharing the message of how important reading is today.
Papa tells me Casey Jones started dreaming about trains when he was littler than me. I think of that big old case of being little than me, and I smile.
Kindergarten and preschool is where it all starts, that love of reading, and there's no better way to get a child to love reading than to pull them in close to your lap and read a story to them. Teachers tell children about the importance of reading, and they talk about the fact that, you know, to be an athlete and to play football at UVA, you have to be a good reader to get to UVA. And I think today, for our older kids, that message was confirmed. The players talked and shared with them that as young adults, they see the value of reading.
Before I go to bed, I have a book on my bookstand, or a book on my nightstand, and read a couple chapters before I go to sleep.
that they spent time today expressing that to the kids just really solidifies the message that teachers give in a much more authentic way. Those students really did hear from the football players that reading is important. Don't just do it because your teachers are telling you to do it, but do it because it's going to take you somewhere. And I can't think of a better, authentic message for children to hear.
Now let's check out this week's schedule of home events in Virginia Athletics. Our softball team hosts Fordham on Monday and Boston College on Saturday. On Tuesday, our baseball team welcomes James Madison and then opens a huge weekend series against Florida State on Friday. Women's tennis also continues ACC play when Boston College visits on Friday. Women's lacrosse has William and Mary on Wednesday and Princeton on Saturday in the first game of a doubleheader that concludes with men's lacrosse against the Ohio State Buckeyes. Also on Saturday, our football team will hold an open practice at Darling Stadium in Hampton, Virginia. We'll be back next week with those game stories and more from Virginia Athletics. I'm Scott Robison. Thanks for supporting the Cavaliers, and go Hoos!
Cavalier Sports Weekly is brought to you by GEICO, the Virginia Athletics Foundation, the Virginia Lottery, and by UVA Health Systems.